Hi students, this is Botany PSR. Today we will discuss about how do enzymes bring about such high rates of chemical conversions. How these enzymes will bring about high rates of chemical conversions? Because how means by lowering the activation energy. By using the enzyme, activation energy is lowered. What is activation energy? What happens if we do not use the enzyme in the chemical reactions? Those all aspects we will study today. Okay, right. Substrate S is converted into products with the help of enzyme. So that is, substrate is converted into products with the help of enzyme. Now E plus S, enzyme plus substrate, gives when substrate is bind to active site of enzyme, which complex will be formed? Enzyme substrate complex will be formed. Complex means more than one unit is there, it is so called complex. Substrate is attached to active site of enzyme, it is so called enzyme substrate complex. Later on, the bonds that are present in the substrate, those are broken and required bonds will be formed and products will be formed. So that is so called enzyme product complex. Later, enzyme and products are released. Enzyme and products, enzyme plus P. E means enzyme, P means products. You have to know the sequence. E plus S or S plus E gives rise to enzyme substrate complex. Enzyme substrate complex, later on enzyme product complex, later on enzyme plus products. Don't say minus, don't say only enzyme, don't say only products. At the end of the reaction, both enzyme and products are formed. What does it mean? Suppose if 10 grams of enzymes are used in the reaction, at the end of the reaction also 10 gram of enzymes is present. That is, enzyme is unchanged both qualitatively and quantitatively. There is no change in the quantity. There is no change in the quality of products also. So that is the point you have to remember. Right. This sequence you have to remember, my dear students. E plus S, enzyme plus substrate, gives rise to enzyme substrate complex, gives rise to enzyme product complex, enzyme product complex, EP complex, gives rise to enzyme and products. So at the end, both enzyme and products are formed. If 10 grams of enzyme is used, means at the end of the reaction also 10 grams of enzyme is present. That is, the enzyme is unchanged, unaltered, both qualitatively and quantitatively. Right, this enzyme substrate complex, which is short lived, don't say long lived. So whenever the substrate is bind to active site of an enzyme, then what happens? The bonds present in the substrate, the bonds present in the substrate will be broken and new bonds will be formed, and then the products will be formed. Okay, so that is, enzyme substrate complex is short lived and transient phenomena. Transient means unstable. Transient means unstable phenomenon, and it is obligatory formation. Obligatory means definite. So enzyme substrate complex is short lived or long lived? It is short lived, don't say long lived. It is transient phenomena. So of the following, which one is a transient phenomena? Means ES, EP, like that they have given, means you have to write only ES, don't write EP. EP means EP complex, ES means enzyme substrate complex. Which one is the transient phenomena? Means that is enzyme substrate complex, don't say EP complex. Right. Next, substrate, whenever the substrate is bind to active site of an enzyme, what happens? the substrate reaches a new state called transition state. The substrate reaches a new structure called transition state. There, the bonds that are present in the substrate are broken. So, substrate reaches a new state called transition state, and then bonds will be broken and new bonds will be formed. Bonds break or make. So, transition state, bonds breaking and making. Of these two, which one is first means? Substrate reaches to transition state, that will be you have to write first, and then bonds will be broken or new bonds will be formed. Later on products will be formed. This is the correct sequence. Transition state is considered as a transient phenomena. Transient means unstable. Transient or unstable, right? Substrate enters into a new structure called transient state structure. Very, very important. Transient state structure, which is transient, which is unstable, right? Substrate and products are stable. In the reaction, which are stable? Both substrate and products are stable. In the middle, products are unstable. The intermediate structural states are unstable. Intermediate structural states are unstable. Substrate and products are stable. Of the following, which are the stable compounds? Both substrate and products. Unstable compounds are intermediate compounds. Next, stability is dependent on. Stability is related to. On which property the stability is depends upon, is related to. That is related to energy status of molecule or structure. Energy and structure. So, the stability is related to both energy and structure of the molecule, right? So, first of all, this sequence is very, very important, my dear students. Substrate gives rise to products means in between these stages are present. E plus S gives rise to, it is a reversible reaction. So, E plus S gives rise to ES complex. ES complex gives rise to EP complex. Finally, gives rise to E and P. Both enzyme and products are formed at the end of the reaction. Of the following, which one is a transient phenomena means? You have to say only ES complex. Don't say EP complex. Okay. The substrate reaches a new structure called, new state of structure called transition state, which is unstable, which is a transient phenomena. Right. What is activation energy? Activation energy means what? That activation energy is available in the form of either heat or ATP. Activation energy is available in the form of either heat or ATP. Right. Let us see this diagram. This is the graph. On x-axis, which was taken? Progress of reaction is taken on x-axis. This is the y-axis. Potential energy is taken on y-axis, and now substrate is converted into products. S means substrate. This is product. S reaches a new structure called transition state. The substrate reaches to a new structure called transition state. There, the bonds in the structure will be broken and new bonds will be formed. Finally, products are formed. Finally, products are formed. So, here this is the substrate and this is the transition state. So, between substrate and transition state, this will be called as activation energy. What is activation energy means? Between substrate and transition state is called activation energy. Between substrate and transition state is called activation energy. So, without enzyme, this is the activation energy. This is the activation energy. So, here without enzyme, substrate is converted into products. See, try to understand, my dear students, without enzyme also, substrates are converted into products. In the last class, we noted that CO2 plus H2O gives rise to H2CO3. In absence of enzyme, 200 molecules per hour. In presence of enzyme called carbonic anhydrase, how many molecules are formed? 6 lakh molecules per second. That means substrate is converted into products both in presence of enzyme and also in absence of enzyme also. In absence of enzyme also, substrate is converted into products, but products number will be less number. Okay, so here we are not using the enzyme. This is the aqueous energy. What is aqueous energy? The difference between substrate and the transition state is called aqueous energy. Here not using the enzyme. So this is called the aqueous energy without enzyme. Now we are using the enzyme. Now using the enzyme means substrate is converted into products. Substrate is converted into products. Now this is the substrate, this is the product, this is the aqueous energy. Previously this is the aqueous energy, now this is the aqueous energy. So this is aqueous energy in absence of enzyme. This is aqueous energy in presence of enzyme. So aqueous energy is lowered, aqueous energy is decreased by using the enzyme. That point you have to remember. Why we have to use the enzyme in the chemical reactions means to lower the aqueous energy. So without enzyme means this will be the aqueous energy. In presence of enzyme means this will be the aqueous energy in presence of enzyme. So aqueous energy will be lowered by using the enzyme. So this will be marked as aqueous energy without enzyme or absence of enzyme. This will be called as aqueous energy with enzyme or in presence of enzyme. So how much this aqueous energy will be lowered means this much, no? Actually this one in absence of enzyme, this is in presence of enzyme. What that aqueous energy lowered means this one. So this would be the here to here. This would be the aqueous energy lowered by the enzyme. What would be the aqueous energy lowered by the enzyme is, in this diagram it is represented as C. In this diagram A is represented as aqueous energy without enzyme. In this diagram B is represented as aqueous energy with enzyme or in presence of enzyme. In this diagram this is C. C is aqueous energy lowered by the enzyme. And next, this will be called as D is transition state, E is progress of reaction, F is potential energy. To explain the aqueous energy, what will be taken on x-axis? This will be the called as x-axis. Progress of reaction will be taken on x-axis. What will be taken on y-axis? Potential energy. X-axis represents progress of reaction, y-axis represents potential energy. What is aqueous energy? The difference between, this is the aqueous energy. The difference between average energy content of substrate and that of the transition state. The difference between average energy of substrate and transition state is called aqueous energy. Why we have to use enzymes means to lower the aqueous energy. In absence of enzyme means more aqueous energy is present. In presence of enzyme means less aqueous energy is there. So why we have to use the enzymes means to lower the aqueous energy. Okay, now look at, and this is the diagram of exothermic reactions. Exothermic reactions. These reactions, chemical reactions, are of two types: exothermic reactions, endothermic reactions. These are the exothermic reactions, also called spontaneous reactions. Exothermic means energy is released. So here is S, here is P. Which is at higher level? S is at higher level than P. Which is at lower level? P is at lower level than S. In which type of reactions? Exothermic reactions. In exothermic reactions, S is at higher level than P, or products are lower level than substrate. Now look at here, my dear students. More activation energy is for in absence of enzyme. Less activation energy is for in presence of enzyme. By using the enzyme, activation energy is lowered or decreased. Why we have to use the enzyme in the chemical reactions means to lower the activation energy. Next, reactions are of two types: exothermic reactions, endothermic reactions. Exo means outside, endo means inside. Exothermic reactions also called spontaneous reactions. Energy is released. Exo means released, outside. This is the diagram of exothermic reactions. S is at higher level than P. Product is at lower level than S, or S is at higher level than P. And these are the endothermic reactions, also called energy required reactions. Energy is required in the form of ATP. And this is the diagram of endothermic reactions. S is at lower level than P, or P is at higher level than S. P is at higher level than S, or S is at lower level than P. These are very, very important points, my dear students. In exothermic reactions, which is at lower level? In exothermic reactions, which is at lower level means products are at lower level than substrates. Whereas in endothermic reactions, which are at higher level means products are at higher level than substrates. So please note down all these points. Now look at here, my dear students. Nature of enzyme action can be explained by two hypotheses: lock and key hypothesis, and second one is induced fit hypothesis. Lock and key hypothesis proposed by Emil Fischer, and induced fit hypothesis proposed by Coastland. Very, very important points. Nature of enzyme action can be best explained by two hypotheses: lock and key hypothesis, and second one, induced fit hypothesis. Lock and key hypothesis proposed by Emil Fischer, and induced fit hypothesis proposed by Coastland. Very, very important points, right? Enzyme plus substrate gives rise to enzyme substrate complex, gives rise to enzyme product complex, gives rise to enzyme and the products. At the end of reaction, both enzyme and products are released, right? which enzyme substrate complex is short lived. This enzyme substrate complex is transient phenomena. Of the following, which one is a transient phenomena means you have to write enzyme substrate complex only. Don't write EP complex. Next, it is obligatory formation. At the end of the reaction, both enzyme and products are released. So, enzyme is unchanged both qualitatively and quantitatively. Quantity, no change. Quality, no change. At the end of the reaction, both enzyme and products are released. This enzyme is unchanged both qualitatively and quantitatively. Right. What are the correct sequence of steps in nature of enzyme action? Let us suppose this is the enzyme. This is the enzyme. Now, substrate. Let us suppose this is the substrate. Now it is binds to here. It is binding. The substrate binds to active site of enzyme. Where does the substrate is binded to enzyme? Active site of enzyme or catalytic site of enzyme. This is so called ES complex. When substrate is bind to enzyme, then it becomes enzyme substrate complex. Now, shape of the enzyme is altered. Shape of the enzyme is altered and it tightly and by fitting more tightly around the substrate. See, this is the substrate, no? Now, the enzyme is like this. Like this. So, that is binding of substrate to active site of enzyme. That is the first step. Later on, shape of the enzyme is altered by fitting more tightly around the substrate. By fitting more tightly around the substrate, bonds will be broken or new bonds will be made. New bonds will be formed. So, bonds break or make. Next, enzyme product complex formed. Enzyme product complex will be formed, EP complex will be formed. Later on, enzyme and products are released. So, first of all, substrate is binded to active site of enzyme. Shape of the enzyme is altered by fitting more tightly, around the substrate. And then, bonds break or make, EP complex formed. Next, enzyme and products are released. Enzyme and products are released. Okay. Now this is the sequence. E plus S gives rise to this is reversible enzyme substrate complex, which is a transient phenomena. Shape of enzyme is altered. Substrate reaches a new structure called transition state. There, the bonds in the substrate will be broken. And when the requirement is there, depending upon the requirement, new bonds will be formed. Shape of the enzyme is altered, later bonds will be broken and new bonds will be formed. So, that is bonds break or make. Later on, enzyme product complex will be formed. Finally, enzyme and products are formed. Here, enzyme only falls, products only falls, E minus P falls. You have to write both enzyme and products, E plus P. Both the substances, both enzyme and products are produced at the end of the reaction. This enzyme is changed or unchanged? Enzyme is changed. That is qualitatively or quantitatively or both? Both. If 10 grams of enzyme is used, means at the end of the reaction also 10 grams of enzymes is present. That means this enzyme is unaltered. Enzyme is unchanged both qualitatively and quantitatively. This sequence is very, very important point, my dear students. Here they will give E plus P, E minus P, E only, P only. Like that they will give. What is the correct answer means? E plus P. Both the substances you have to write. Enzyme and products. So, please note down all these points. I hope you understood and we will meet in the next class.